Welcome to 8th episode of Brics Garden Book Lecture Series. We are doing this series continuously from last 7-8 weeks. In the previous 7 episodes that we have learnt about various things about urban foodscapes and especially that about the seeds, seedlings, the growing medium, the container and all these things that we have learnt. As we move on, we have to understand more about the planting methods, planting practices. So, depending upon the type of seed, depending upon the duration of the crop, depending upon the scale or the spread of the crop, so we have to understand different methods of planting, most particularly for the vegetable crops which we are trying to promote as urban foodscapes in container gardening. So, this has there are two methods basically. One is direct planting, the other one is transplanting. Let us try to learn about both these methods in this episode or probably in the next episode as well. Let me explain about the planting of leafy vegetables. Leafy vegetables are the ones which are generally small seeds where we generally harvest them in bundles. And they are of very short lifespan. They can be harvested in about 25-30 days time in a good growing conditions. So generally we use the containers which are wider and narrower or the less deeper. So for leafy vegetables we don't need deeper containers. See, something like this kind of tray is more than sufficient for leafy vegetables. So anyway, all other things are common, that we have to make drain holes at the bottom. And you have to fill up, so especially the soil like Bengaluru, not necessary that we have to fill up gravels at the bottom because it is a loamy soil, but at the same time, so the soil in black cotton soil kind of area where Hubli, Dharwad or Bijapur in Karnataka, or anyway the more clayey soil, so you may have to use the drain holes very nicely, and at the bottom that it has to be filled with some kind of gravel so that it is water is easily drained out, excess water is easily drained out. And of course not necessary that you have to use gravels, you can use coconut shell pieces, you can use broken pots, you can use coconut husk made into small pieces. Dry leaves can be put at the bottom, so that way, so different type of materials can be put at the bottom. So then prepare the growing medium, especially we have learnt in our previous episodes that the good growing medium is a mix of one portion of compost, one portion of vermicompost, one portion of cocopeat and one portion of soil. So that is the best growing medium for container gardening. So that way the growing medium has to be mixed and it has to be filled up. So initially whether it is for direct planting or whether it is for transplanting, so you have to fill up about 60% of the containers. See, for seeds like amaranth or maybe seeds like methi, coriander, palak, so they are generally not that big seed, they are small seeds, and at the same time they are not individually planted. See, if we tell them to use one seed for planting individually, then it is absolutely not possible. So it is so such a small seed and you need to have lots of patience to plant individually. Generally these kind of small seeds or the leafy greens are broadcasted in the growing medium. So broadcasting means that it is the spreading of seeds. But what happens generally is that we are not experts. So sometimes that it will be too thick a planting and sometimes it will be too thin a planting. So for that it is generally mixed with a spoon of seed is mixed with a spoon of dry sand. But in urban foodscapes or in urban farming situation, what happens is getting dry sand is also not easy, very difficult. So for this purpose, generally we suggest to use the broken wheat, so as dry sand. So this can be mixed nicely. so that it will be very uniform in broadcasting. So then slowly the seeds can be broadcasted. So after broadcasting, so the seeds can be covered with little bit of growing medium again from the top. So these are small seeds, so too much of growing medium on the top probably make them very deeper planting, so then they may not emerge out properly. So we have to have a very thin coverage from the top. You can just compact it. So in general sense, probably the depth of planting should not be more than 0.5 centimeter. So they are so small seeds, so it should not be more than 0.5 centimeter. So like that, see, if we have coriander seeds, so we can just see the coriander seeds. So they are quite big, they are not that small seeds, they are quite big seeds. So these seeds also can be broadcasted very thinly. And again covered with the growing medium from the surface, from the top. So little bit compaction. One day probably generally the growing medium will be wet. So if it is not wet, slowly we may have to put water. If you have water can, it is fine. Otherwise, just by holding the hands to the mug of water, slowly that it can be. So this planting is done. It is the pot is ready, and we may have to keep it for germination for about 6-7 days. For germination, that it can be kept in even in shade also. Once it germinates, we have to move the container to the terrace or where the light is sufficient. For the leafy vegetables also, at least minimum 2 hours of direct sunlight is a must. So similar kind of bed has to be prepared for crops like or the underground crops like radish, carrot, even for potato, beetroot and other things. But potato, of course, this depth of the container is not sufficient. We have to have a container of at least 15 to 18 inches for potato. Now let me show you how the radish is planted. So generally radish farmers, they go for broadcasting also, but in urban situation it is better to go for dibbling. For dibbling we may have to make small holes like this from the surface. So this is a kind of row planting only. So between plant, between rows, there will be at least 2-3 inches of space required. We don't have much space. Farmers leave at least 6 to 12 inches of space between plants and 12 inches of space between rows. But we don't have that kind of luxury to have so much of space between plants and between rows. So let us have at least 3 to 4 inches of space between. So like that, it will be around 16 to 20 plants per square feet. So that much of seeds that you can or the plants that you can have per square feet. So in case of leafy vegetables like coriander, chili and other things, at least up to 25 seedlings can be there in a square feet. So here it will be 16 or much lesser. So like this, that we have to put one or two seeds in each hole. So if you are not sure that whether there will be 100% germination, that you can put two. Otherwise you can just put only one seed in each cavity or in each hole. Then cover this and sprinkle water and keep it for fridge. Radish germinates faster, so in 3-4 days time that you will see the seedlings and like that. See, like this carrot. So carrot also can be carrot is also again a small seed, so it is not a big seed. So carrot is a small seed, and you can go for broadcasting, but otherwise it can be dibbled with a spacing of about, so in this kind of container, if you have a wider container, the part of this can be radish and part of this can be carrot. So that way also that sometimes that you can mix, but some carrot is a small seed, putting one seeds may be difficult. So if you put too many seeds, then you have to thin out and maintain only one seedling in the later stage. So like this, so you have to carrot takes little more time for germination, about 8 to 10 days. So then again sprinkle water and keep it for germination in shade. So then another method of direct planting is dibbling, seed dibbling, what we call. See, just I showed you dibbling in radish. Similarly, there are some seeds which are quite big. There also we have to prepare the pots as earlier. So we may have the drain holes at the bottom. That is a must. And of course, this is an used pot. So we have to reuse and reuse the containers as much as possible in the terrace gardening or urban farming situations. So you have the drain hole. So to encourage to draining, so we have the gravels at the bottom. So whatever type of gravels that you want to put, that you can put. The seeds can be treated with trichoderma or any other type of biofertilizers or the bio inoculants, what we call. So that kind of treatment, if it is available, that we can always treat. So in urban gardening situations, as of now, that we are not using that much of bio agents, we have to start using. So as we move on, so in a standard system, that it is better to use the bio inoculants. So it should add to the better growth of the plants. So then the seeds of anything above the size of bendy, what we say, if we suggest to use one seed per planting, then it is possible to put one seed. See, it is possible to dibble one seed. So anyway, if it is if you are not sure of germination, then you can put two seeds, just press it. So it is generally what we say is the depth of planting is the double or triple the size of the seed, depending upon the type of seeds. So just cover this for this kind of container of 12 inches, so or 1 feet by 1 feet by 1 feet, 1 cubic feet space. So one plant at the center of the container, so that is sufficient. So this gives a spacing of 1 feet between the plants. So just imagine that you have one more container, so and you have dibbled the seeds at the center of that container, so then between the plants will be about 1 feet. So that much of spacing is required for the crops like bendy, crops like beans. So beans also similarly, that it is again an quite big seed, it is not a small seed. So in this kind of similar containers, that you can put one seed at the center of the container, bush beans. So then so you have to cover this, so you have to sprinkle water. So it's a big seed, it germinates faster in 7-8 days that you will seed the seedling, and as it grows, so you have kept this much of space, and this space is for adding additional top up growing medium. As it branches, you have to give a handful of growing medium. As it flowers, that we may have to give a handful of growing medium. As it starts fruiting, we may have to give a handful of growing medium. So that way, so we have kept about 60% of the space for this kind of the bushy type of plants like bendy, like bush beans, like the other type of bush type of plants like tomato, chili and other things, where we need to have this much of additional space at the top to give the top up. So by the time the plant is having flowers and fruits, the container has to be full with growing medium. Then this gives a very good growth opportunity for the plants to grow. See, this kind of containers, little more wider, little more deeper containers can be used. See, for crops like creeper beans, see, like this, that you can just dibble two seeds. So this is the bottle gourd, maybe ridge gourd, bitter gourd, cucumbers, ash gourds, pumpkins, all those things. This kind of the wider, deeper containers are required. So similarly, for direct planting like spinach, so you can use the similar kind of containers. For that also, so I am using the same container for the demonstration purpose. So this kind of wider containers and deeper containers can be used for direct planting also. This is sufficient for crops like rhizome, rhizome crops like ginger, turmeric. So that also can be used, grown in this kind of containers. So as it grows, apart from the compost that you can give the liquid nutrients like panchagavya, jivamrita, or from Brics that we have a formulation called Pytonic Plus, which can be added once in 15 days at the rate of 5 ml per liter to boost the growth of the plants in the initial stages. So today we have learnt about direct seeding. So as I was discussing with you, see, the direct seeding has two methods. One is broadcasting and another one is seed libbing. So depending upon the type of crop that we have to practice this kind of this one, probably you have learnt little bit, and if you have any doubts that you can always write to us. So subscribe to our YouTube channel www.bricsbio.com or just Brics Bio in YouTube. So this will bring us more interaction, and we can always give us more information about urban foodscapes. Thank you so much for watching.